Hello everyone, this is Sri Radha Dev Roy, your sociology educator. I hope you all are doing very well. So in this video, we will be discussing the origin and emergence of sociology. Now before going into the details of any discipline, you must have some basic ideas about the subject. So you must have the meaning of the subject, the definitions of the subject matter, the reason of its origin, future scope of the subject, etc. So I have already made a video on introducing sociology. So in this video, we will be discussing the emergence of sociology. So in this video, we will be covering the following points. That is, why did sociology originate? When did sociology originate? Where did sociology originate? And how did sociology originate? So by the end of this video, I am sure you will have an answer to all of these four questions. So these are my qualifications. Now before going into the details of the video, please do not forget to hit the subscribe button so that you do not miss out any of the videos uploaded in this channel. Now see, though sociology as a discipline emerged only in the 19th century, people have been thinking about society since forever. So philosophers from various parts of the world have been writing about society from their very own perspectives. For example, Kautilya's Arthashastra, Manu's Smriti, Aristotle's Politics, Plato's Republic, etc. However, many of these books were mostly philosophical in nature, that is, they were based on speculations and untested assumptions about society. They often involved grand schemes. What is meant by grand schemes? So these were basically generalized assumptions about society, which were done without actually looking into the workings of society. Now a question arises as to what happened that suddenly led to the emergence of a whole new discipline of sociology. Were the other discipline of social sciences failing to answer the questions of society? Let us look into the video to get into the details of that. So you see, sociology was born in the 19th century as a consequence of the intellectual and social forces prevailing in Europe. So we will be looking into the intellectual and social forces that prevailed in Europe, which led to the emergence of sociology in the 19th century. So first we will be dealing with the intellectual forces. Now what is meant by intellectual forces? This basically means those relating to ideas or intellect. So these will include the mental powers or the powers of ideas that influenced the rise of sociology in Europe. So the first intellectual force we have is that of the Enlightenment, which occurred between 1715 to 1789 in Europe. Now, the Enlightenment was a set of ideas about man, society and nature which challenged the traditional worldview dominated by Orthodox Christianity. So, the Enlightenment stressed on the importance of science. It said that scientific knowledge could be applied to analyze all the phenomena around human beings. Secondly, it stressed on individualism. It said that individuals should not be subjected to any higher religious authority, and they are themselves the starting point of all knowledge. Third, we have the concept of progress. So the Enlightenment ideas said that by the application of science and reason, human social conditions could be improved and thereby humans could have an ever-increasing level of happiness and well-being. The fourth we have is the concept of rationality. Rationality means reasoning, so we must use our reason to judge everything around us and not blindly rely on religious faith. Finally, we have empiricism and science. Now, what is empiricism? Empiricism means verifiability. That is something which can be verified through scientific methods. So, the empiricism and science basically means here that the social world is verifiable through the senses. So one should not follow tradition but use our senses to judge the social world around us. The next intellectual force we have is that of the philosophy of history. Now, the basic assumption of this philosophy was that society must have progressed through a series of steps from a simple stage to a complex stage. So this passage of development from simple to complex stage involves development and progress of society. This also gives us a concept of the historical periods through which every society must have progressed. Now the influence of the philosophy of history was further influenced by the biological theories of evolution. As you all know, this was propounded by Darwin. Now what happened was that sociologists tried to identify and account for the principal stages in social evolution. So it started becoming modeled on biology. So society was often compared to living organism, as you can see in the writings of Herbert Spencer and Emile Durkheim. Finally, we have the survey of social conditions. So survey was basically a scientific technique which was used to collect data. Now it was believed that the method of natural sciences could be used to study human affairs. So survey as a method of natural science could be used to study society and its social problems, which would give the detailed data about the workings of the society. Second is the movement for political and social reforms. So basically, in view of the political and social reforms which were taking place in Europe, which we will be discussing shortly, so these made the social thinkers realize that poverty as a social problem was not natural. Why? It was social. Why was it social? Because it was understood that it was not given by God or some religious entity. Rather, poverty was a cause of exploitation or some other social factors. So it was understood that by using survey method, one could collect exact data about the social conditions and the social problems, and by actually collecting the exact data, one could solve the problem of the society accurately. So till now we were looking at the intellectual forces, or the forces occurring in the level of intellect or ideas, which led to the emergence of sociology. So now we will be looking at the social forces. What are the social forces? These are those forces occurring at the level of society or the societal level that led to the emergence of a whole new discipline of sociology. So now we have the Industrial Revolution, which occurred in England between 1760 to 1840. So this was a period of rapid industrialization. What is meant by industrialization? Industrialization is basically the growth of industries on a large scale in a particular region. So this was accompanied by rapid mechanization or use of more and more number of machines. So what happened was that the agricultural society was getting transformed into an industrial society. So the ancient and medieval beliefs and customs were also getting destroyed. So you see, industrialization basically gave way to a new logic called capitalism. Now, what is capitalism? Capitalism is basically a logic in which the trade and industry of a society are controlled by the private owners, whose main aim is profit maximization rather than the welfare of the citizens. So as capitalism emerged, and societies became more and more complex. So there occurred the development of banks, insurance companies, financial corporations, which came in the scenario. So a new class of industrial workers, managers, and capitalists emerged. Now you see, as the agricultural society was getting transformed into industrial society, it was accompanied by a large-scale urbanization. So these agricultural workers were now migrating in large scales to these urban centers. So now they found themselves more and more in unhygienic and poor conditions in these urban areas. So in the cities, the socio-economic disparities were becoming very wide. The factory workers were involved in repetitive and boring work, which the fruits of which they could not enjoy. In Marxist terms, the workers were becoming alienated from the product of his or her labor. In this new industrial society, there also occurred a transformation of property. So, while previously the society was agricultural society, the stress was on land. So land was the main form of property. Now when the society is getting transformed into an industrial society, then money or capital becomes the main major form of property. Now in case of cities, the social thinkers saw these new cities as storehouses of misery and inhumanity. They also thought that the technology and factory system would alter the human life for all times to come. So all these situations concern the social scientists to a large extent. So Marx saw in this a form of enslavement in the machine and a manifestation of the alienation of labor, while Weber saw in this an iron cage of capitalism. Let me know if you do not know those concepts. I will be discussing them in great details in some other video. Now the social scientists were concerned with this altered form of interaction. Now as I had said before, sociology was concerned with human interaction. So these altered form of interaction in society was a major concern to the social thinkers. Next we have is the French Revolution, which occurred between 1789 to 1799. Now, what happened here is that the feudal power structure was uprooted. Now, what is feudalism? Feudalism is basically roughly the idea of holding land in exchange of service or labor. So, while feudal power structure was uprooted, the principles of democracy, liberty, and equality was established. So, we have then changes in the family system. So marriage, which was previously considered as a divine grace, was now transformed into a civil contract. So how does it become a contract? So divorce was introduced. So after the French Revolution, everybody was allowed to participate in the making of law. Emphasis was given on equality. Recruitment to services was done on the basis of merit and not on the basis of class. Now, before French Revolution, marriage was also undissolvable and was considered to be one of divine grace. But after the French Revolution, the marriage became a contract which could be dissolved by the help of divorce. So after the French Revolution, the power was removed from the clergy or the churches and the feudal lords to the common people. Now you see, all of a sudden, a lot of changes were happening in society. The traditional pattern of life was dissolved. The new industrial society was characterized by a lot of disorders and social problems. There were economic inequalities, poor living conditions, overpopulation, which was occurring due to excessive urban migration. So in this backdrop, there was a need to address these problems in society. Now to solve a problem, you need to understand a society better, its workings better. So there was a need for a discipline to address the problems which other social sciences like the economics and political science was failing to address. Now this need to solve the problems of the society gradually gave birth to the discipline of sociology. The social scientists felt that sociology would try to understand the workings of society better so that it can solve the problems of it. Now to understand the exact workings of society, there was a need they felt that the principles of natural sciences could be applied to the social sciences. This Auguste Comte was the first who stressed the need to analyze social life scientifically and adopted the scientific methods of analyzing society. As he said, to know, to predict, to control.
That is, the methods of natural sciences could be used scientifically to know, to predict, and to control the social problems. So therefore, sociology emerged as a discipline which they aimed would contribute to the welfare of society.
Now, in the early years, sociology assumed a variety of characteristics. So first, it was encyclopedic in nature. Now, what is meant by this is that as an encyclopedia is a book which gives information on many subjects, similarly, sociology was concerned with whole social life of man and with the whole of human history. Secondly, it was evolutionary in nature, which was influenced by the biological theories of evolution as well as the philosophy of history. Thirdly, it was conceived of as a generally a positive science. Positive here means scientific. So it was conceived as a positive science which is similar in characteristic to the natural sciences. In the 18th century, the social sciences were conceived broadly upon the model of physics. In the 19th century, it was modeled upon biology, which is evident from the conception of society as an organism, which is prevalent in the writings of, say, Durkheim and Spencer. Fourthly, in spite of its claim to be a general science, sociology deals particularly with the social problems arising from the political and economic revolutions of the 18th century. It was above all a science of the new industrial society. So while it claimed to be a general science, it became a specific science of the industrial society. I hope this video was helpful for you all. Let me know if you want me to discuss any point separately. I'll try to make a video on that as well. If you like this video, please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe.